Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Arpita Sharma Classes. I am Arpita Sharma, your educator, and today we are decoding the Hindu newspaper for 20th September 2019. On page number 1 you will find this very interesting news, Kiladi findings traceable to 6th century. Now this is very important piece for prelims as well as for GS paper 1 history portion, and your history optional also. Now here you can find Kiladi is a small village near Silaiman, which is on the border between Madurai and Shivagangai district in Tamil Nadu. So there is a report by Archaeological Survey of India. The name of the report is Kiladi, an urban settlement of Sangam age on the banks of river Vagai. So this report has said that the cultural deposits in the Kiladi village have been found, which dates between 6th century BCE to 1st century BCE. The results of the report is second urbanization of Vagai plains happened in Tamil Nadu around 6th century BCE. First urbanization Indus Valley civilization ya Harappan civilization bolte hain jisko, use kehte hain. Second phase of urbanization kehte hain ki Vedic civilization ke time par hua tha. But yahan paya gaya hai ki jo first urbanization tha wo to Indus plains mein hua tha, Indus Valley civilization. Jo second urbanization hai wo Tamil Nadu mein 6th century BCE ke aas pas hua tha. The date of Tamil Brahmi script pushed back to another century, that is 6th century BC. So basically this report links the scripts of Indus Valley civilization with the Tamil Brahmi script. Indus Valley civilization ki script ko Tamil Brahmi script se link karti hai ye report. Kaha jata hai ki Indus Valley civilization first urbanization thi, to second urbanization phase Tamil Nadu mein shuru hua tha. It is said through this report that the first phase of urbanization happened in Harappan civilization and the second phase happened in Tamil Nadu, wherein the Tamil Brahmi script was invented. The society in Kiladi has used animals for agricultural purposes like cows, buffaloes. Recovery of spindle whorls, pinpointed bone tip tools were found, which hints towards the weaving industry, spinning yarning industry, looming industry. So you can say there was urban civilization in Tamil Nadu, which is contemporary to the Gangetic Plain civilization, that is the Harappan civilization. Jo Tamil Nadu mein civilization chal raha tha na, wo samkaleen tha Harappan civilization ke. Now in this news you will read about carbon dating. What is carbon dating? This question can come in your GS paper. What is radiocarbon dating? Explain the science behind radiocarbon dating and examine its applications. In 200 words, they can ask you this question. Very important. Radiocarbon dating kya hai? GS paper 1 mein ek question aa sakta hai. Aur kya science hai radiocarbon dating ke peeche? So radiocarbon dating is also known as carbon dating. It is a method used to date materials that once exchanged carbon dioxide within the atmosphere. Yani ki material kab originate hua, ya ye jo haddi mili hai, ye kitne time purani hai, kab mara gaya ye janwar ya ye insaan, ye sari baatein carbon dating ke through pata chal sakti hain. Access to internet is a basic right, says Kerala High Court. So over here, this is very important news. Ye bahut hi important hai. Kerala High Court has said that right to have access to the internet is part of fundamental right to education and also right to privacy under Article 21 of the Constitution. Kerala High Court ka manna ye hai ki jo right to access the internet hai na, internet ki ka jo right hai hamara ki hum internet access kar sakte hain ya nahi, ye fundamental right to education ka hissa hai. Plus ye hamare Article 21 of the Constitution ke under bhi aata hai. So restrictions on use of mobile phones amounted to a violation of fundamental right to freedom of speech and expression under Article 19 subsection 1 sub clause A. As per Kerala High Court, agar mobile phone use karne pe college university mein restrictions lagaoge to kya hoga? Iska matlab aap fundamental right to freedom of speech jo hame mila hai uska khandan kar rahe ho. Even United Nations General Assembly has also declared right to internet to be a human right in 2014. Again, very very important point for GS paper 2. United Nations General Assembly ka bhi manna ye hai ki right to internet jo hai wo hamara human right hai. The fundamental freedom under Article 19 subsection 1 clause A can be reasonably restricted also only for the purpose mentioned in Article 19 subsection 2. Ab ye jo Article 19 subsection 1 clause A hai na, right to freedom, hamara fundamental right to freedom of speech and expression, is pe restrictions bhi lagai ja sakti hain, but kuch hi conditions mein. It authorizes, this Article 19 subsection 2 authorizes government to impose by law reasonable restrictions, logical restrictions upon the freedom of speech and expression. Article 19 subsection 2 ke tehet government authorities reasonable restrictions laga sakti hain is right pe, right to internet ki right pe, plus freedom of speech and expression pe. Kaise? It can be imposed in the interest of sovereignty and integrity of India. When it comes to protection of our country, then yes, restrictions can be put. All right. Alka Lamba disqualified from Delhi Assembly. Here anti-defection law is important. Anti-defection law was passed by Parliament over here, you can see, in 1985 and reinforced in 2002. 52nd Amendment to the Constitution included the 10th schedule, which is known as anti-defection law, which aims at preventing the participants or the politicians from frequently shuffling between political parties. Aisa nahi hai ki apne man mutabik kabhi ek party mein baithe hain, kabhi dusri party mein baithe hain. Anti-defection law ke tahat unko hum keh sakte hain house se bedakhal bhi kar sakte hain. Apne ghar se nahi, parliament se. It disallows the MPs, MLAs to switch parties after elections. And the speaker or chairman of the house is the authority to decide on defection cases. Faisla kaun leta hai? Speaker ya chairman. Alright? Clear everyone? 10th schedule defines the following terms: legislative party, original political party and elected member and nominated member. 10th schedule ke tahat ye terms ki definition maujood hai. Legislature party, the group of all members of the house who belong to a political party is a legislature party. Original political party, the political party to which a member of the house belongs to, that is original political party. And highlight this particular term, because this term is only defined in 10th schedule. Okay, ye term sirf 10th schedule mein hi keh sakte hain aap diya hua hai. An elected member belongs to a political party if he contested in the election as a candidate of that party. A nominated member, it belongs to a political party if he was a member of the party on day of nomination, and he can become a member of political party within a period of 6 months from the date on which he takes the seat. Alright, the nominated member bhi political party ka permanent member ban sakta hai. Next important topic, Ola drivers to get healthcare benefits under Ayushman Bharat. Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana partnered with Ola. Now the Ola drivers will also be covered under this program, this scheme. ये जो आयुष्मान भारत प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना है ना, जो सितंबर 2019 में अभी लॉन्च की गई है, ये क्या करती है? इट प्रोवाइड्स हेल्थ केयर ऑफ रुपीज 5 लाख इन गवर्नमेंट इन इम्पैनल्ड प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल्स टू 10.74 करोड़ इकोनॉमिकली डिसएडवांटेज फैमिलीज. सो नाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर पार्टनरशिप बिटवीन आयुष्मान भारत प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना एंड ओला एम्स टू ईज फाइनेंशियल बर्डन ऑन दी ओला ड्राइवर्स. It will provide comprehensive health insurance for secondary and tertiary care to the Ola drivers. And because of this agreement and MOU also has been signed. India unlikely to meet Poshan Abhiyan, find study. This particular study suggests that India is unlikely to meet targets set under the ambitious Poshan Abhiyan or National Nutrition Mission. हमारा जो विश्व का सबसे बड़ा न्यूट्रिशन प्रोग्राम हमने लॉन्च किया है ना, एक स्टडी के तहत ऐसा माना जा रहा है कि इंडिया अपना टारगेट नहीं अचीव कर पाएगा. 2022 तक हमें स्टंटिंग, अंडर वेट, लो बर्थ वेट, अनेमिया, इसको कम करना था ना वुमेन और चिल्ड्रन में, तो वो टारगेट हमारा मीट नहीं हो पाएगा. पोषण अभियान वॉज लॉन्च इन 2018. टेलीकॉम बॉडी ओकेज रुपीज 8,500 करोड़ फॉर मोबाइल टावर्स, ऑप्टिकल फाइबर लेइंग. डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन कमीशन, विच इज द हाइएस्ट डिसीजन मेकिंग बॉडी इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ टेलीकॉम, अंडरलाइन दिस, इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रीलिम्स. इट हैज अप्रूव्ड मल्टीपल प्रोजेक्ट्स वर्थ ओवर रुपीज 8,500 करोड़. And the approvals have been granted for setting up mobile towers, laying up optical fiber with an aim to provide improved connectivity. Connectivity को और strong और बेहतर बनाने के लिए mobile towers लगाए जाएंगे, optical fibers का network बिछाया जाएगा. And the approvals include special scheme to cover close to 12,000 uncovered villages. इस approval में ये scheme pass की गई है कि जितने भी aspirational districts है ना, कम से कम 12,000 uncovered villages है जहाँ पर connectivity पहुँचाई जाएगी. लेइंग ऑफ भारत नेट फाइबर इन दी नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न स्टेट्स, अरुणाचल प्रदेश, असम और मेघालय में भारत नेट फाइबर बिछाया जाएगा. भारत नेट इज वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट रूरल ब्रॉडबैंड कनेक्टिविटी प्रोग्राम विच यूजेज ऑप्टिकल फाइबर. ऑलराइट, CDSCO लुक्स टू टेक मोर प्रोसेसेस ऑनलाइन. सो CDSCO हैज फाइनलाइज्ड एन इनिशिएटिव विच एम्स टू एनहांस द ट्रांसपेरेंसी एंड ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस ओवर नेक्स्ट टू ईयर्स. CDSCO क्या है? इट्स सेंट्रल ड्रग स्टैंडर्ड कंट्रोल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड इट्स अ नेशनल रेगुलेटरी बॉडी फॉर इंडियन फार्मास्यूटिकल्स एंड मेडिकल डिवाइसेज. ओके, फॉर प्रीलिम्स यू हैव टू स्टडी सुगम पोर्टल. प्रीलिम्स के लिए आपको ये ई गवर्नेंस सिस्टम पढ़ना पड़ेगा, सुगम पोर्टल. इट इज यूज टू डिस्चार्ज वेरियस फंक्शंस परफॉर्म बाय CDSCO. इट्स एन ऑनलाइन लाइसेंसिंग पोर्टल ऑफ CDSCO विच वॉज लॉन्च्ड इन 2016. ओके, सो मेक अ नोट ऑफ दिस सुगम पोर्टल फॉर योर प्रीलिम्स. Now this is how you have to make notes. I have given you the idea of making notes from the newspaper. Likewise, you can make the notes from the editorials also. Okay? Thank you and have a nice day.